இங்கே வந்திருக்கும் தொழில்நுட்பர்கள் இன்னைக்கு புரட்சிகரா வார்த்தைகள் இன்னைக்கு தமிழ் ரொம்ப தெரியாது. So whatever I'm going to say next is going to be English. I'm extremely sorry. I cannot speak in your language. There will be a language gap. But I think the language that all of us understand, that's the language of struggle. The language of independence, democracy, socialism. That is the language I think all of us are connected with. Before I start my speech, I want to congratulate the Tamil Nadu State Committee, Kamru Uchi Makali, for their constant intervention. From youth exam to Anita to Jallikattu, all the issues, all the political issues, all the student issues that has happened in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu SFI was the first one to react in everything. I want to congratulate and extend my revolutionary greeting to all the contestants in Tamil Nadu. At the same time, I want to use this opportunity to thank, to congratulate the contestants from Kerala. Congrats, Vijil is here. We have seen how in Kerala, Student Federation of India is making history. Student Federation of India in Kerala is the first organization to give membership to transgender community. Student Federation of India this time, for the first time in the history of Sanskrit University, an all-women panel is there for the election. Every candidate from SFI is a student, is a woman comrade. I think in a regime where there is a person like Modi is sitting in the center, where if you are a woman, you will be told that you should sit inside your house. If you are a Dalit, you will be told that you should commit suicide. There is no place for you in this country. There is no place for you in this university. I feel proud. I feel proud that the people from the marginalized community, let it be women, let it be Dalit, let it be Muslim, they chose Student Federation of India as their platform. They chose Student Federation of India as their tool to struggle against the same parivar. I feel proud about it. Comrades, as I'm going to talk about what is happening in Uttar education right now, we all know that there is a planned attack against education. It is not like that only after the BJP coming, there is an attack. When Congress was there was also a planned attack against education. But after BJP coming in this government, we have seen how public institution has been targeted. We all know what happened in JNU. We all know one fine morning, Smriti Irani told that all the scholarship what he will use to get will be closed. We said that this scholarship is our right. We sat there in front of UGC for a month, we occupied UGC for a month and we have taken back our life. They have told that your Indian president Kanhaiya Kumar is an anti-national. They have put him under the bar, under the jail. We in the student community of JNU and the whole India, the student community, the progressive community, the student federation of India stood in the street and said, no nationalism, no anti-nationalism, you are going to teach. You the people, you the follower of Savarkar, who has given letter to British asking sorry, that please we are not going to do independence struggle anymore. We are talking to teachers what is independence, what is nationalism, what is anti-nationalism. We have seen what is happening there. We have seen how now they are again targeting JNU. Earlier in every PhD we used to have 1,000 seats. Now suddenly UGC coming and saying there is not going to be any admission in the NCL and PhD. Yes, there is attack. There is also attack from the ABVP. We have seen a student in JNU, Najib Ahmed, who has been disappeared by the same ABVP people. There is a two-sided attack. One side through administration, the Sankh Parivar, and inside the student community, this ABVP, this tools of administration, who will divide you for your religion, who will divide you for your gender, who will divide you for your caste, and is going to divide the student movement. But if oppression is their right, then resistance is also our right. The Student Federation of India in JNU was proven for last 2 years, not giving a single seat to ABVP in the central panel. The Student Federation of India, the student community in JNU was thrown ABVP in the dustbin. Not only in JNU, Pandit Vijin was telling, see at Rajasthan, not only ABVP, even NSU is thrown out. Look at Himachal Pradesh, look at Kerala. In most of the places, wherever there is election is happening with the Student Federation of India, which is winning the Students Union election. And there, we are not only fighting RSS, we are also fighting another fundamentalist like SIU. Student Federation of India is the only organization we are at the same time fighting the Hindu fundamentalists and also the Muslim fundamentalists. We feel very proud. During a juncture when there is a wholesome attack against the education, when there is a wholesome attack against the student community, Student Federation of India across the country, in every campus, they have stood as a vanguard of the student community. In this time, I also want to say that there is a, for the people who are poor people in this country, there is a problem. If you are poor in this country, there is no place for you. If you are poor in this country, you cannot go to school. Because the fee will be so high that your parents will be able to afford. If you are poor and if you are Dalit, things are more complicated. If you are poor and you are Dalit and somehow you come to the schools, there, just because you are Dalit, you are going to be discriminated further. You are going to be sat separately. You are going to ask to clean the toilets. You are going to be discriminated, not going to be given marks, and at the end of the day dropped out because you are Dalit. You know what happened to Rohit Vimula. If you are poor, if you are Dalit, and after that if you are a woman also, Mata, there is no problem. We have seen what happened to Anita. A woman who comes from a wage laborer family, a woman who comes from a Dalit family, who is for one time only not poor. But just because she didn't go to fancy CBSE school, just because she didn't surrender in this Hindustan kind of idea, she had to suicide. This society, this regime had forced her to commit suicide. We think that this is the time when the student community of this country is going to stand here, stand with all the Amita, stand with all the Rohit, and fight the struggle for social justice. The day the very sad incident with Amita happened, the very next day, Tamil Nadu Student Federation of India was on the streets. We have told them that you can cut the flower, but you can't stop the spring from coming. You can kill one Anita, but instead of that one Anita, thousands of Anita, thousands of Rohit are going to come to your streets and take back the right from you. I'm not going to lengthy my speech. One morning I came, Chandru was telling me that they have to go to court today. What was their fault? They are fighting for meat. They are fighting against meat. They are fighting for social justice. The administration, the regime thinks that if they put cases against us, we are going to be scared, we are going to get afraid, and we are going to stop doing activism. I want to tell them that this Tamil Nadu is the land of Shonu and Sambhu. These two people who have given their life for fighting for what right? Don't show us this case and all. We have seen this enough. This is Student Federation of India. I want to hear mention about Comrade Rakesh Sinha. Comrade Rakesh Sinha, the first General Secretary of Himachal Pradesh University from Student Federation of India, was also booked in different cases and spent months in jail. Now what happens? After coming to the jail, this person goes to the masses, he builds mass organization, he does trade union, and today, when a saffron assembly is being elected in Himachal Pradesh, Comrade Rakesh Sinha is on the next star rising there, giving the bread to the voiceless, talking about the masses. I want to congratulate and want to take pride that this is what Student Federation of India is. No matter how much lathi charge you do, no matter how much you put us under the jail, we are going to come out and going to show you what Student Federation of India's real strength is. With this, with just a small story, I will conclude my speech. It's a story of a boy named Venkatesh. Venkatesh is from a very poor family, a Dalit family from Andhra Pradesh. Venkatesh's parents are wage laborers. They migrate from one place to another to survive. So Venkatesh, when he was 7 years old, he was admitted to a residential school. Now this residential school, there is no proper food, there is huge corruption, the warden does not listen, the principal does not listen. This Venkatesh went and told to the principal that this is not the way things are going to happen. One day, this Venkatesh mobilized all his classmates and took the food to the principal's office and said, this is the food that is given to us. If you can eat this from tomorrow, we are also going to eat. If you can't eat, we are not going to eat. The principal said, listen, you are a small boy, you behave yourself. There was warning given to Venkatesh to not to do this further. But what to do in the revolutionary spirit? One day, this Venkatesh met a boy from SFI. This boy took him to the headmaster's office and showed, but see, there are photos of so many people. There is photo of Gandhiji, there is photo of every other person, but there is no photo of Ambedkar. The boy named Venkatesh, who comes from a Dalit family, felt that somehow the representation, somehow these people who talked about Dalit right, who talked about social justice, are ignored. The very next day, this Venkatesh organizes people, organizes his classmates, and put a photo of Ambedkar in this principal's office. Now this principal, being very offended, very next day, dismisses him. He was disqualified. He was told that you have done a gross indiscipline and you will be removed from the school. Now this Venkatesh doesn't have anyone back home. His parents are migrant laborers, they go here and there. There is no home Venkatesh has. So Venkatesh has to leave school. Venkatesh left school one whole day. He was starving, trying to get job here and there. Nobody gave visa, 7-year-old kid. So a whole day he starved. Then he slept just beside the road. Morning he met a rat picker. This, he's also a young boy who takes from that game, we take things and sell them. So from when this boy and this rat Peter, they became friends and they started living. For a month, the Venkatesh spent his life like that. One certain morning, one comrade from SFI, who has brought him to the Student Federation of India and told him that in the principal's office there should be Ambedkar's photo, met him in the street and found the kind of distressed situation Venkatesh is. This boy, the SFI comrade, took him to a street children's school and Venkatesh was admitted. Within one year, Venkatesh completed the course of class 9, course of class 10, and he was admitted in an engineering college. After completing his engineering, he has given the entrance examination in political science for Hyderabad Central University and Jawaharlal Nehru University. He cleared both of them and right now he is a student of Jawaharlal Nehru University. Student Federation of India thinks that our primary responsibility is to make sure that all these Venkatesh who are dropped out because of their caste, because of their class, because of this society, should be given back the chance to go and study in HC, to go and study in Jawaharlal Nehru University. I feel very proud that this Venkatesh is an executive committee member of Jawaharlal Nehru University, SFI today. He goes to JNU and raises the slogans of independence, democracy, socialism. I think all of us are here. This is our responsibility to make sure all the Venkatesh we see, all the Rohit Gamula we see, all the Amita we are going to meet, we are going to make sure that their life is not going to have the same kind of sorrow, the same kind of death, the same kind of sadness what these other people have. With this promise, with this spirit, I want to say that all of you who are here, we are doing the same battle. We are warriors, we are soldiers of the same battle. Together, we can change everything. With this spirit, with this belief, I want to thank the Student Federation of India Tamil Nadu again, and I hope in years to come, we are going to see bigger and bigger mobilization in Tamil Nadu, and the Student Federation of India is going to be the vanguard of student community here. Thank you, and Kalab Zindabad.